gathered the people to lead them in salah. He led them in salat al-dhuhr. As soon as the prayer had finished, he returned back to the minbar. He then stood and addressed the people, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, I am requesting from you all, if there is anyone who has anything upon me, then come and take it from me. If there is any money that I owe to anyone, then please take it from me now. If I have hurt anyone, or if I have cursed anyone, or if I have been wrong to anyone, or have oppressed anyone, or I have hit anyone, then take your recompense now, take it from me now. And he repeated this again and again and again. The narrations in the books of hadith and history are many about what happened at this moment in time. One of them, which is not so strong, but strong enough to give an indication, narrated in the Majma' Zawaid of Al-Haytami, he said that one man stood up. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I need to take recompense from you in one thing. The people turned around. They looked at this elderly man. They recognized him as Ukasha. Ukasha ibn Muhsan al-Asadi, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They were shocked. They were shocked because this is no normal small fry. This is one of the mighty companions, one of the senior companions. Ya Rasulullah, on the day of Badr, when you were making the sufuf, you were straightening the lines and you took your stick to straighten the lines. And you pushed me back and you hurt my chest. You pushed me back with your stick and you hurt my chest. Ya Rasulullah, I only stand up now because you have asked for it 3 times. Ya Rasulullah, I want to take back what is my haqq. The companions were beside themselves. In all of these narrations, you will see, regardless of their weakness, in Abu Bakr as-Siddiq stands up, Umar stands up, Sayyidina Ali stands up, one by one, we will take it out on me, 10 times on me, 100 times on me, any money you wish, please don't go to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What are you doing? One by one, each time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, hey, to Sayyidina Ali, your position with me is well known, you don't need to prove anything to me. Hey, Hassan al-Hussein, you're okay with me, I know your position, you don't need to prove anything to me. This is fine, this is what we need to do. Go and bring that stick. Go and bring my stick. The stick was brought. The companions were... What's going on? The stick was given to Ukasha. Ukasha came forward to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam opened up his shirt and exposed his chest. Ukasha took the stick and he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he threw it to the side and then he kissed the chest of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He kissed the chest of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I only stood up because I wanted this to be the final ahad between us. I wanted this to be the final thing between us. I just took my opportunity. Ukasha. Ukasha, the giant of the companions. Ukasha, who has already forgiven his sins because he was at Badr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already told him, do what you want. فَقَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَكُمْ. I have forgiven you what you want to do anyway, so go ahead and do anything. Ukasha, who stood by the Prophet ﷺ and fought by his side so fiercely that he broke his sword into so many pieces and he still tried to defend the Prophet ﷺ. He said, Ya Rasulullah, my sword is broken. The Prophet ﷺ gave him a branch, a piece of wood. He said, take this. He didn't question him once. He took the branch and he used a piece of wood against other people's swords and from the mu'jizah of a Nabi ﷺ, this branch turned into a sword. The sword of Ukasha, which the scholars gave a name to, Al-Aun. And he continued to defend the Prophet ﷺ with that sword in Al-Badr. And he continued to use it for the sake of the Muslims until he himself was killed, shaheed, at the Battle of Al-Ridda with Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. This is Ukasha. Ukasha, one of the mighty people who goes to heaven like, bam, like that. He has a path to heaven that we can only dream of, that the companions can only dream of. The Prophet ﷺ in Bukhari said, 70,000 members of my ummah will enter Jannah without hisab, without azab. No questioning, no punishment, just green card goes straight through. While the companions are thinking, how does one do that? The Prophet ﷺ said, these are the people who have that perfect tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perfect trust. The companions now trying to work it out. How does one get that? What does one do? What's the levels required? Yani what actions? Ukasha is like, you know what? You lot think about this. Ya Rasulullah, pray to Allah, udu Allah yaj'al minhum. Make this dua to Allah that He makes me from one of these 70,000. Anta minhum ya Ukasha. You are from them. You are from them. He's already been given it. And as I said to you, the rest of the companions can only dream. Because when another one stood up, he said, ya Rasulullah, and me as well, huh? Sorry, Ukasha got there before you, my friend. And he has. فَقَدْ سَبَكِ Ukasha. He has got there before all of us. This is Ukasha.